MAS Rajudin. Today we are going to discuss about elasticity of demand. In that particularly we will see about income elasticity of demand. Let us move on to the next slide. Elasticity of demand. What is elasticity of demand? Elasticity of demand is, it is the extent of change of demand. What happens to demand when one of the factors on which demand is dependent on changes? Demand is dependent on many factors like price of the goods, disposable income of the consumer, price of related commodities, and so on. When one of these factors changes, the demand of the commodity changes. Now we are going to measure the extent. How much is the demand is changing when these factors are changing? And one of the factors changes by, let us say, 5%. When the income increases by 5%, how the demand increases? How much is the demand increase? That we are going to calculate in elasticity of demand, that is income elasticity of demand. Now let us take a look at the close factors, closely at the factors which are affecting demand. One is price of the goods. Second thing is disposable income of the consumer. Disposable income means income minus taxes. That is what consumer gets to spend. That income also affects the demand of the consumer. Price also affects the demand of the consumer. Price of related commodities also affect the demand of the consumer. How the price of related commodities affects means, for example, let us take two SIM cards, okay, Jio and Airtel. In that, when Airtel price is changing, the demand of Jio also changes. That is the factor, price of related commodities, which affects the demand for a commodity. When the price of other commodity changes, its related commodities demand also changes. See how income elasticity of demand is calculated. For example, we can calculate income elasticity of demand as follows. Elasticity is equal to percentage change in demand divided by percentage change in income. By this method we can calculate the elasticity of demand, that is income elasticity of demand. The formula is percentage change in demand divided by percentage change in income. In this manner we can calculate how much the demand changes when there is an income change. For example, we'll see example. For example, let us take luxurious goods like diamond. We are taking the luxurious goods like diamond. In the diamond, the percentage change in demand for diamond is 50%. When there is an income rise of 20%, income is rising by 20%. In that case, the demand is rising by 50%. Okay. We have numerator, the percentage change of demand. In the denominator, we have percentage change in income. When the income rises by 20%, the demand for diamonds rises by 50%. Then we can say diamond has income elasticity of 2.5. Okay, the final value, the elasticity value is 2.5. What is this 2.5 means? We can say when there is a 1% income rise, the demand for diamond rises by 2.5%. That is the final value. Elasticity, income elasticity value is 2.5. That means when there is a income change of 1%, the demand for diamond increases by 2.5%. We have a positive value of 2.5, which indicates that as the income rises, the demand for diamond also rises. That is the conclusion we have. The next slide, in that there is a proportion method. In the proportion method of calculating income elasticity of demand, what is the observation is, here the observation is, when the proportion of income spent on the goods increases as income increases, and when the consumer is having more and more income, he is spending more percentage of his income on the good. That is the proportion. Okay, proportion means what is the percentage of income he is spending on the goods. Initially he is spending some 10% of his income on the good. When his income is increasing, he is increasing to 12.5%. Let us take our income level as follows. We have considered diamonds example. In the diamond example, we shall continue. When the income of the consumer is 1 lakh, he is spending 10% of his income. That is, total expenditure spent on diamond is rupees 10,000. Next, when the income is 1,20,000, he is increasing his percentage of income. Since diamond is a luxury good, when the income increases, it is highly likely that he will increase his percentage spent on the diamond goods. When the income increases to 1,20,000, he is spending 12.5% of his income. So the expenditure comes to 15,000. That is, 1,20,000 into 12.5% gives us 15,000. When the income is 1,00,000, he is spending 10%, that comes to 10,000. When the income is 1,20,000, he is spending 12.5% of his income on diamonds. Okay, now let us take an example as 1 unit of diamond is equal to 5,000 rupees. So price is 5,000. Expenditure divided by price gives demand for diamonds. Okay, in the first case, 10,000 divided by 5,000, the demand for diamond is 2 units. And the demand, when the expenditure is 15,000, 15,000 divided by 5,000, we get the demand as 3. Okay, now we know that for calculating income elasticity of demand, we know the formula as percentage change in demand divided by percentage change in income. That is the income elasticity of demand formula. Now we will apply this formula and find out the income elasticity of demand. We know how much the income increased. Income increased by 20%. 1 lakh to 1,20,000. 1,20,000 minus 1 lakh. That is new income minus old income divided by original income. New income minus original income divided by original income into 100. Then we get the percentage increase in income. That is 20%. 1,20,000 minus 1 lakh. 1,20,000 is the new income. Minus original income is 1 lakh. Divided by original income 1 lakhs into 100, we get 20% is the increase in income. Now we calculate how much is the increase in demand percentage. How much percentage of increase in demand happened? That we calculate now. Percentage increase in demand we can calculate as the new demand is 3 units. The original demand is 2 units. New demand 3 minus original demand 2 divided by original demand, that is 2, into 100. That gives 50%. 50% is the percentage increase in demand. Now we can easily calculate the income elasticity of demand. Income elasticity of demand is the percentage change in demand divided by percentage change in income. We can calculate as 50% divided by 20%, we get as 2.5 is the income elasticity of demand. 2.5 is the income elasticity of demand. Now what is this 2.5 means? That is, when there is a 1% change in income, the demand changes by 2.5%. When the income, here we get a positive value, that means when there is an increase in income by 1%, we get the increase in demand as 2.5%. That is the inference we have. That is the understanding we can have from this. So we can conclude, when the proportion of income is increasing, as the income increases, income is increasing 1 lakh to 1,20,000, proportion of expenditure also increases 10% to 12.5%, then we get the elasticity value as greater than 1. That is, 2.5 is greater than 1. We get the elasticity value which is greater than 1. 2.5, we get final elasticity value which is greater than 1. This is the inference we are having. That is, when the income is increasing, when the proportion of expenditure also increases 10 to 12.5%, income is increasing 1 lakh to 1,20,000, proportion of expenditure also increases 10 to 12.5%, then we will get the elasticity which is greater than 1. Here 2.5 is greater than 1. That is the inference we are having. Okay. Thank you all. We will see in the next video.